everyone, and welcome to the new topic which we are going to discuss today, that is unmanned aerial vehicle, also in short we call UAV, and also most popularly known nowadays is drone. So how remote sensing can be done? Of course, these are the vehicles for remote sensing, but nowadays for various purposes they are also being used, even for putting insecticide or pesticides in the agricultural fields. But we are not going to discuss those things. What we will be focusing mainly on the how in the field of remote sensing these platforms can be used. As you can see that there are variety of drones now are being used, especially one has to focus on the payload, what type of camera it is having. So basically the advantage with these drones that they have become quite simpler to handle, and the other big advantage is with them is they are very stable. As propeller, number of propellers are more, like in this example there are 4, so they remain quite stable in space, and better photography or remote sensing can be done. Of course, the other advantages are like these are unmanned, so no pilot is there on the vehicle itself, but a pilot is on the ground. So these are very lightweight relatively, and also these are also nowadays equipped with GPS or GNSS receivers, so they can be also controlled through control stations, or they can be programmed so to do the automatic survey employing this GNSS technology. So all kinds of technology integrations are happening with nowadays with UAV. UAV basically were originally used for missions that were dull, dirty or dangerous for humans. Still these are being used, and these drones are also being used extensively in military applications. Even they are being used, and in this one they are loaded with some missiles and plan, and then they execute this thing. There are commercial applications are also there, and many people apart from scientific applications, recreational applications are also there. I have just briefly mentioned also agriculture applications. Nowadays for crowd monitoring or policing also it is being used for peacekeeping, surveillance, and even they are being used to deliver some products. But the product need not to be very heavy, because these cannot carry very heavy load, but now slowly powerful UAVs are also coming, drones, and what we would like to focus mainly on this aerial photography or remote sensing. There are some other recreational things like drone racing and other things are there. So the civilian, because they are relatively not very cheap, not very expensive, and even people can buy online, so that is why they are now outnumbered with military UAVs, that civilian UAVs, and there are millions sold by 2015. So a lot of applications of UAVs are coming. As you know that when we didn't have the current or modern day technology, but the concept of UAV was already there, unmanned aerial vehicle. In 1918 these were tested. In 1936 more improved version also came of US Navy, earlier also was US Army, and then in Vietnam War, which was fought by US for very long time, about 30 years, they have used these Firebees which were again UAVs, but the most modern one, the current one, which are very lightweight and very robust, and is very stable also. So they are having either rotary wing or multi-rotator are there, or propeller. And of course, the advantages are that they are stable. Disadvantage, the battery life is a problem because all these motors have to run on batteries. Sometimes the loss of controls are also there. So when you are having rotary wing, these are the advantages and disadvantages. But advantages in rotary wings that they can be used for surveillance or surveying, also for remote sensing. Whereas the fixed wing, which are given here, fixed wing like this one or this one, they generally have longer battery life, but they require to be launched. Fixed wing also better for large areas coverage and needs open area for takeoff and landing. So there are limitations are there. Most popular nowadays are the rotary wing or multi-rotator UAVs are there. Now payload on UAV, that's the main important thing, that what kind of camera or sensor which has to be installed with that one, that is very important. That payload basically is the weight a drone or UAV can carry, and it is usually counted outside the weight of the drone. So if drone is having weight of say 1 kg, then if you are having sensors, then that is additional load. So one has to know exactly the capacity of UAV, how much payload it can carry, and accordingly the sensors or cameras are installed with the UAVs. A greater payload of UAVs are being also thought to carry multi sensors, greater payload, and that is also now being becoming popular. There are also like camera to a dual thermal and RGB imaging systems, very common nowadays. Also people are experimenting with LIDAR technology, because the biggest advantage, as I have said, these are very stable platforms, so they can be used for the LIDAR technology. And of course they are having the GPS system or GNSS system inbuilt, so they can be controlled or planned, the surveys can be planned very precisely, accurately. And these number of sensors are now increasing, the possibilities of using UAVs are becoming much larger. And this is one of the examples of a little bigger UAV, and that is also here, that weight versus flight time. So if you go for heavy payload, because of battery will be consumed lot, so the flight time may be less. So it's a sort of inverse relation. So flight time is guaranteed to be reduced when carrying extra weight, purely because of the additional power required to lift it. And that, so judiciously it has to be assessed that how much time is required to cover a part of terrain, how much payload is, and what is the battery backup. So all these things have to be assessed before such surveys are initiated. There are number of different types of payloads available nowadays for different purposes, for different applications, and with different capabilities. So UAV sensor payload can include such as high definition video photography, very common payload on UAV, which are being used for various purposes. Thermal imaging, which is again very important, especially in case of disasters and others, like an earthquake or others. One, if there are humans which are trapped in the rubble of the buildings, then probably these thermal sensors on board of UAV can help to a large extent. Also these UAVs can be used to monitor the radiation level, because going in areas where radiation may be very high and may be dangerous for human, but such machines can be sent for those surveys. Also volatile organic compounds, also this particulate matter of 2.5 and more. So where human is not safe, UAVs can also be used depending on the requirements. Thermal imaging, as I have just mentioned, is becoming very powerful tool along with this UAV or drones, and it can be used by many other sectors like construction, mining, electrical, surveillance, firefighting, search and rescue. So, lot of applications of UAVs are in natural disasters and rescue operations also. Advantages, first few advantages we have already discussed. Nonetheless, UAVs are accurate because they are having GNSS controls or signals receivers. They are flexible, means payload can be changed. Their heights can, the survey heights can also be changed, and the relatively low cost for measurement of 3D, three-dimensional mapping. Also, radiometric and temporal properties, and temporal properties here that in many times in a day in area can be surveyed. So, much higher than our normal remote sensing to cover different types of features on the ground or different happenings. And the only requirement is quality cameras, payloads, GPS and precise processing. This part I would like to emphasize more here, because these are providing lot of data, huge data is coming through UAVs based surveys, and the processing requires very special softwares, not the standard one, and georeferencing sometimes also becomes challenging. So, and because many times these things are recorded in the video form, in digital video or high definition videos, and then rest of the processing is done to develop certain products, maybe a land use map or maybe a digital elevation model or other things. So, that is why the processing, intense processing is there, and a lot of challenges are still there. And the other advantage with UAVs is that they are available in the wide ranges, size and shapes, number of rotating motors, maybe 4, 6, 10 depending for what purpose and how much stability is required. Their deployment is of course very easy. Cost effectiveness we have already discussed, which is definitely better compared to conventional airborne or spaceborne systems, and that is why these are becoming more popular, more attractive for in order to cover a small area. But if one would like to cover a large area, then probably UAVs are not fit for those kind of tasks. They are also light based systems relatively, and the height typically they can fly between 100 to 200 or 300 meters, and accordingly depending on the height, the aerial strip or footpath extent will also vary typically to few kilometers. Huge amount of data is provided by the UAV, which I have already said, and therefore challenges towards developing appropriate processing. Storage is also very much required, and transmission techniques. Transmission techniques, because each UAV or payload which is doing the survey need to record, and sometimes need to transmit the data direct through a direct broadcasting to the receiver. So, if enough storage is not there, then transmission might be required, and sometimes in real time on a TV monitor, one would like to see what the UAV or the payload is surveying. So, the near real time or real time transmission is also required. So, that becomes a necessity in certain kind of UAV based remote sensing. Storage also required, very much required for serious UAV based remote sensing, so that the data later on can be analyzed. Applications, various applications, and this is not exhaustive list. and new different type of applications are getting here, adding and are getting added almost every day. So, of course, if we start with the aerospace military, I already told you that this is, and they are in military application, they are also using very big and which can carry heavy payloads also. For reconnaissance survey, they are being used. Defense against UAVs, again UAVs are put against UAVs. In archaeological survey, in cargo transport, in conservation, in healthcare, in filmmaking, in videography, and in hobby recreational use, lot of people are buying small UAVs for their own hobbies. Of course, scientific research, they are being used UAVs. I also mentioned earlier in natural disaster scenarios, these are being used extensively for search and rescue operations. For surveillance, for crowd monitoring, that is also being used. Serious remote sensing based surveying also being used. Pollution monitoring, in profile, doing profiling of say PM2.5 or others in the atmosphere, that can also be done. Oil, gas and mineral explorations and productions, these are being used. And of course, disaster relief and relief and rescue operations. Agriculture extensively nowadays, and these are being used not only for survey but also spraying insecticide and pesticides and to the target or affected plants. And police is also extensively have started using these things, because if they fly by helicopters, they are helicopters are having limitations compared to UAV, and therefore these can be so. And n number of applications are already there. People are developing more applications as different types of payloads, more efficient payloads with better storage capabilities are becoming available, and these are becoming very, very popular. Here a few examples I can discuss, which is directly related with how UAVs are being used in remote sensing. So, first one is the land surveying. Of course, 2D maps can be created, and digital elevation models can also be created. These products are from there only, and GIS or 3D mapping can also be done using UAVs. In civil engineering, for infrastructure inspections, a big bridge has come. Now, we would like to inspect how it is performing, or are there any problem. So, it can be used for bridges, cell phone towers, power lines, solar panels, as in the picture it is shown that it is being used for bridge. And of course, the feasibility surveys also, maybe for transportation routes or other things. Railways have also started using for these UAVs for even maintenance or finding out faults on the lines. Mining people have also started using for volume calculations and other related operations in the mining industry. Agriculture applications like crop monitoring, as you can see here that there might be some problem in here in the plants, so that has been surveyed. Now targeted pesticides can be put, so it saves a lot of pesticides and other things. It can go there. So, crop monitoring, disease, insect, weed, crop progress, crop stress, all these things can be studied depending on the what type of payloads are put in the service. Chemical applications, fertilizer applications, pesticides applications in large agriculture fields where it becomes difficult for human, these UAVs, little powerful, which can carry a lot of load, can be employed. Land management also, these can be used for drainage related issues, replanting decisions, yield estimations, soil moisture surveys, again UAVs are being used. Environmental related studies, forest fires very common in Garhwal Himalaya of India. Every year in the month of April, May, June, and when the moisture or humidity is very less, some are natural or some are man-made forest fires are seen. So what is the extent of forest fire? And even if these UAVs can carry big payloads, then these can also be used to extinguish small size fires. And deforestation studies can be used in coastal area. It can be used for to find out the coastal erosion and doing mapping. Wildlife, of course, it can be used for animal counting or many kind of wildlife related activities. In humanitarian efforts, in the rescue operations, in disaster mapping, when this Nepal earthquake in 2015 in April 25th occurred, many UAVs were employed for search and rescue operations. And later on also, these UAVs can be used for post-disaster assessment. Hazard monitorings for like in volcanoes, difficult for human, but the UAVs can be put in service for glaciers, for flood. So, in earthquakes also, and landslides, and this list we can keep adding. Emergency deliveries, see here medicines are being delivered to a target location. So, another very good advantage of UAVs, the UAV is carrying the box, box is having medicines, and these can be delivered. There might be a loss of road connectivity or no other possibility of delivering emergency medicines. These can be delivered by UAVs also. So, this brings to end of this discussion related with UAVs. We have seen various types of UAVs. We have seen or discussed various types of applications associated with UAVs. Currently, the list is not exhaustive, and many new applications are being added almost every day. We have also discussed about advantages and disadvantages associated with UAVs. So, this brings to end of this discussion. Thank you very much.